Phacoemulsification in presence of anterior capsular tears can be completed successfully. However, in a good percentage, there can be associated complications. Subsequently, there's always a surgical dilemma of whether to convert to ECCE or to continue with phacoemulsification in the presence of these tears. Carifi et al. Have reported complications in phacoemulsification with anterior capsular tears like concurrent PCR, nucleus drop, and poor refractive outcome. The classical signs of posterior capsule rupture are sudden anterior chamber deepening, pupil snap sign, sudden increased fundal glow, reduced fallibility, nucleus tilt, and nucleus drop. The shortcomings of these signs are that they do not appear instantly, and the time lag for recognition of the signs varies according to the expertise of the surgeon. We present a flap motility sign, which conclusively helps to decide the extent of the anterior capsular tear. The anterior capsule tear can be either pre-equatorial or it can extend beyond equator onto the posterior capsule. Pre-equatorial tears have everted and fluttering flaps. Phacoemulsification can be easily continued safely. The everted and fluttering flap moves around the pivot formed at the endpoint of tear extension in response to the pressure gradient dynamics of the anterior chamber. In this video of anterior capsular tear having Argentinian sign and intumescent cataract, the phacoemulsification is carried out using safe phaco technique. While doing phacoemulsification, the vigil is being kept on the flap motility sign. The flap is fluttering and everted in nature. At no point of time, the flap becomes inverted and stops fluttering. In such situations, the surgeon is carrying on using safe nucleus phacoemulsification techniques and looks for classical signs of posterior capsule rupture. Here, with the knowledge of flap motility sign, the surgeon has to add constant observation of flap motility sign in his surgical protocol. With the flap motility sign in armamentarium, there is no dilemma and the surgery is successfully completed. When the flap stops fluttering and becomes flat, it indicates the extension beyond equator onto the posterior capsule. When the flap becomes inverted, it indicates the further extension of tear. If the phacoemulsification is continued, there can be a nucleus drop. With post-equatorial extension of the flap, the continuous downpulling makes flap taut, flat, and then inverted, making it unresponsive to pressure dynamics. Thereby, high intraocular pressure in the AC, the fluid dynamics in the bag, the weight of the lenticular content, and posterior segment negative pressure cause further extension of tear and the bag contents to move posteriorly. In this second video of the resident doctor, the capsular axis enlargement is being done. While sculpting, one can appreciate the fluttering of the capsular axis flap by the arrow marker. This signifies that the anterior capsular tear has not extended beyond the equator. The surgeon attempts division of the nucleus. With the second attempt, the flap becomes flat and stops fluttering. This indicates the extension of the tear beyond the equator. The surgeon, oblivious of the significance of the flap motility sign, continues. Eventually, the classical signs of posterior capsule rupture occur. In the study of flap motility sign at our center, 25 cases were included. In the 21 cases of wherein the flaps were everted, there was no posterior capsule rupture. Similarly, all the flaps which were fluttering did not have a posterior capsule rupture. In all four cases of inverted, non-fluttering flaps, there was a posterior capsule rupture. The flap motility sign, unlike the classical signs of PCR, appear instantly. It helps the surgeons of varied expertise to know the endpoint of safe phacoemulsification, thereby reducing the complications. With the recognition of the flap motility sign, since we can appreciate the extent of the tear, we can be decisive about continuing phacoemulsification or converting. The knowledge of the flap motility sign helps the surgeon to conclusively decide about the safety of intraocular lens implantation in the bag. Now, the new surgical gaze makes all the difference in surgical experience in the presence of an anterior capsular tear.